Let's take a moment to rest and plan our next move.
Stop that! Thank you. Thank you.
I don't need an umbrella. But you can use one if you need.
Time to sneak in some dim sum first?
Thank you for comp. Ad Astra.
Let's finish this swiftly.
I will bring my notebook.
Justice will prevail! Stop right there! Drop your weapons! Stop!
Illusion shattered!
Faster? Okay, rise.
Flames! Purge!
There is no escape!
The mortal plane. A fleeting dream.
Time to sneak in some dims.
Let's finish this, swiftly.
Wheel of life.
I suppose this will do.
Time to begin work?
Let's finish this swiftly.
I await your instruction. Time to begin work?
Take heart. Victory will be ours.
Kamisato Ayaka, present.
What's our objective?
Training never hurts.
Let's finish this swiftly.
As per our contract. Next on the agenda?
The one before.
This realm is... If you ever...
Way behind schedule.
Thank you.
Better than nothing.
Shine down!
Got it. I'll start my warm-up routine.
Armed and ready.
What's our objective?
We'll need a strategy.
Hey, when you put it like that, it makes it sound like I'm always the one losing.
Ah, perfect, you're all here. There's an important commission I need your help with.
All right, I've got the time. Where are the goods?
It's not just goods this time. I need you to escort a tea merchant and their wares from Qiaoying Village to Liyue Harbor. A very important client has requested to meet with him.
Sure. What's this merchant's address?
We're here.
If the client's that important, then this must be a very crucial, very pressing commission, right?
Of course, the sooner you complete it, the better. I would advise you to depart as soon as possible.
Don't work too hard now, Longzhou. We'll set off then. There. I'll take a rain check on that.
merchant heading to Liyue Harbor. We're here to escort you.
Dad?
Oh, so you're Gaming's father. It's nice to meet you. Just leave this delivery to him. Trust Paimon, he's got this in the bag. Gaming is super good at what he does. Everyone at the Secure Transport Agency says as much. Even the Ministry of Civil Affairs has nothing but good things to say about him.
Seems like you've made some sort of name for yourself, at least.
The goods are all in order?
Yes, they're all here.
Then let's get going.
A very important client has asked for you by name. You kinda have to come with us. Paimon doesn't know how we would explain ourselves if you just didn't show up. Plus, you'd be missing out on a huge money-making opportunity.
I see. I suppose I will have to trouble you all to escort me, then. Let's go.
This place looks nice and open. Why don't you all rest here for a second?
Huh? What about you? You're not going to join us?
I'm not tired. I'll keep watch.
Oh, but...
Just let him go.
Okay, we'll just share amongst ourselves then. Did you know, Uncle Yip, that the flavor of these cakes changes depending on...
Halt! Who goes there?
It appears that one's movements were overly conspicuous.
Enough of your musings. Focus. Focus on the matter at hand. Present your exquisite ornaments at once.
Indeed. Bring them forth readily and without protest.
Ah! What do we do?
It seems as if these two are acting alone. It won't be difficult to subdue them, but they might have something else waiting in store for Dad. The best way to keep him safe is... Leave this to me. I'll handle them. Traveler, Paimon, take my dad and the goods away from here.
No, Gaming. It's too dangerous!
This is what I do.
A thorny foe indeed. Let us depart and seek a target softer in blows and disposition.
Don't think I'm gonna let you off so easily.
Away. Let us away.
Coming!
Don't worry, he's a great fighter. Paimon's even seen him take down a dozen or so treasure hoarders all by himself!
But, Gaming, I... If he had just stayed by my side and learned the family trade, he wouldn't have to put himself in such dangerous situations.
We just have to trust him. Let's go on ahead. We'd best get away from here, in case there are other bandits in the area waiting in ambush.
All is going to plan.
Okay, we should be good to stop here. Zhongli? Oh no, what is he doing here?
Good sir, please, listen to me. Reel in your line and leave this place as quickly as you can. There are bandits in the area.
Bandits? Acting in broad daylight? Oh. Ah, I see. It appears many people are catching a chill as of late. If your throat is bothering you, Paimon, perhaps some tea and rest are in order.
Nope, no need, no need. Paimon's fine. She just, had some cake stuck in her throat.
If there are indeed bandits in the area, then we should inform the Millilith at once. Oh? Well, if that's the case, such matters are best left to those with the necessary expertise, wouldn't you agree?
I suppose you're right. If ordinary people like us got involved, we would only cause more trouble.
Since we find ourselves otherwise unoccupied in this beautiful area, why don't we find a quiet place to relax while we wait for good news?
That would be lovely.
So, Uncle Ip does have a reason to be worried. After all, Gaming, the guard we mentioned, is his son.
Gaming. The name sounds somewhat familiar. Ah, yes. That is the name of the Usho dancer who has been performing around Liyue Harbor recently, is it not?
Oh, have you seen him perform?
Indeed. I cannot help but admire his skill. He truly encapsulates the spirit of the Suani. Usho dancing has become more well known in Liyue Harbor recently. However, although performers are seeing budding success, they have no doubt had to face many hurdles along the way. One's not so easily understood by spectators such as ourselves. If you ask me, what truly deserves admiration is perseverance in the face of adversity. That is a rare attribute indeed. I have heard many of my acquaintances praise Gaming for his kind, selfless, and courageous disposition. To have a child so accomplished and upright, you must be a very proud parent indeed, Uncle Ip.
Seems like Zhongli has decided to skip the formalities.
He's a hard worker, yes.
You should be sure to tell him you think that when he gets back.
Your son is young yet. It's normal for someone his age to be a bit hot-headed. It's understandable to find talking about such things in person difficult. If there's a particular sentiment you wish to convey, perhaps we could pass it along for you.
No, no. It wouldn't be right to ask that of you. This thing between us has festered for many years now. In truth, there are some things that simply aren't easy for us to talk through. I've been in the tea business for most of my life, and I always hoped my child would do the same. Otherwise, how would he support himself? Over the past few years, I heard how well he was doing for himself as a guard. How his work was taking him to farther and farther off places. I also heard that he never gave up on wuxiu dancing. It made me happy. But I was also worried. When you're young, you can handle all that physically taxing work and manual labor. What young person isn't capable of making a living that way? My concern is what happens when you get old. Every time I get to thinking like that, I cannot help but be reinforced in the belief that I was right. That I was right not to give in. I often regret introducing him to wuxiu dancing as a kid. If I had known how things would turn out, I would have never taken him to see those performances in the first place.
It is only natural for a parent to strive to send their child down the right path. No one would begrudge you that sentiment, Uncle Yip. You need not worry.
You seem quite young, Mr. Zhongli. Yet you speak with such wisdom. Perhaps I have misjudged your age.
Your words are too kind. Truth be told, one of my old friends has several grown daughters. Rather than fretting about their future, however, she prefers to let them find their own way.
Then she's more easygoing than I could ever be. I fear I lack such an open mind. I meant to say earlier, there is no need to be so polite. Feel free to call me by my name, Yip Tak.
Sure.
So, do you also think I fret too much, Mr. Zhongli?
That's not exactly what I was hoping to convey. Only a fool would ask a parent not to worry about their child. But think of it this way. Raising a child is not unlike flying a kite. Hold the string too tight, and it can no longer soar. As my friend once said, if your children are aiming for the stars, clipping their wings will only cause them to come crashing down. You need to let out the line for a kite to soar.
It seems I was too stuck in my ways.
You need not reproach your heart for caring. You simply need to loosen your hold a little. Indeed, with such a big heart, why not allocate the time you usually spend worrying about Gaming to the pursuit of other things, like going for a stroll, drinking tea, or taking in the scenery? You never know what surprises could be in store. Things can change in the blink of an eye.
The blink of an eye, you say? Do things change so quickly?
Children grow up in quite the same way, do they not? Day after day, year after year, sometimes in the blink of an eye, but always when you least expect it. As a father, I'm sure you know that best.
Yes, you can say that again. One second, Gaming was a kid. The next thing I knew, he was ready to fly the nest.
Zhongli certainly has a way with words. Oh, Gaming is back! Hey, Gaming, we're over here!
Dad, Traveler, Paimon. Good, you're all here. Oh, and Mr. Zhongli from the Wangshang Funeral Parlor? You're here too?
A fated meeting indeed. We were just enjoying some pleasant conversation.
Is everything resolved?
Well, you could say that.
What does that mean?
Traveler, Paimon, come with me. I need to talk to you. I'll come right out and say it. Those two bandits, you sent them, didn't you?
So that's how we're starting off?
Can't look me in the eye, huh? Guess I'm right then.
Okay, but how did you know?
At first, their mannerisms seemed a bit stilted. But once I got close, it was obvious that they possessed great skills. I was right on their tail, and it should have taken only a few steps to catch up to them, yet somehow, I was never able to close that distance. People with that level of skill would have gone about things differently from the start, like sneaking up on us while we were distracted. Unless, of course, their real motive was to lure me away from the group all along.
Wow, you're pretty quick on the uptake.
I just have a lot of experience. I've dealt with many a ruthless bandit in my time, but I've never seen ones like them. In the end, I told them they would make good guards if they ever wanted to get back on the straight and narrow, and that they could hang out with me in Liyue Harbor anytime.
You ever consider you might be a little too good at making friends?
I'm guessing you guys were trying to help resolve things between my dad and me? I appreciate it, I really do, but this conflict between us has been going on for a long time. Even if those two were real bandits, and I was able to subdue them and show them what I was capable of, it wouldn't change anything. You've seen the way he talks to me.
It's not like that at all! Your dad really cares about you. You should see the way he talks about you when you're not around. Zhongli was talking things through with him, and he nearly agreed to let it go. You don't believe us?
He won't let it go. He can say as much as he wants to other people, but he won't talk to me. I'm certain of it.
You told us you wanted to prove yourself to your dad. Why don't you tell him about all the hard work you've done these past few years?
Will that even do anything? I'm not sure talking is enough.
You won't know unless you try. Just like how you won't know if something is delicious unless you taste it. Listen to us. It's time to put these people skills to good use. You can make friends with anyone, so why not your dad?
I'll do my best.
You are very knowledgeable, Mr. Zhongli. I'm impressed. Despite my being in the tea industry for several decades, it seems, I still have much to learn about the art of tea tasting.
You flatter me. It was nothing but a few humble musings.
How much tea have you drank since we've been gone?
Yip Tak and I have found many a common interest. Our friendship, much like a cup of tea, seems to grow stronger the longer it has to steep.
Well said, Mr. Zhongli. Gaming, Mr. Zhongli is very knowledgeable. You should take the opportunity to learn from people like him when you're in the city.
Huh? Oh, of course.
Ahem. Zhongli?
I have very much enjoyed our conversation, Yip Tak, but I, unfortunately, have some unfinished funeral parlor business to attend to.
Oh, I hope I didn't keep you. My apologies for taking up so much of your time, Mr. Zhongli. No need to stay on my account. When you're less busy, let's find a time to meet. I'll treat you to dim sum.
It would be an honor.
We'll see you off, Zhongli. You two have a nice chat, all right?
Should we sit?
Sure.
Thanks for helping us talk things through with Uncle Yip. Good thing you were able to pick up on what we were putting down.
I have been around the both of you for some time now. You could say I have a certain level of expertise in that regard. As for my role in the conversation, think nothing of it. I hardly did anything noteworthy.
You never change, do you? Why did you have us walk all this way? Paimon thought we just had to go far enough to be out of earshot.
A friend approaches.
Hello.
Xiao! You're here too?
I've been here the whole time. A ghostly kite. Could that elusive Director Hu be coming to Wangshu Inn once again? What is she doing here? I suppose it matters not. Given her relationship with Rex, well, Zhongli, I might as well go pay my respects. It's you! I thought you were Director Hu.
Ah, your arrival is most fortuitous. Do you want to try out this new gadget? The addition of the power source makes the takeoff more stable. It's just that...
He seems quite immersed in the study of this device.
I fear it's almost too stable. It completely negates the pleasure of seeing one's kite sway with the wind. It's a bit of a shame. In truth, I'm here because Director Hu dispatched me to purchase some items in preparation for Lantern Rite.
I see. Much like she does every year. Much like she'll do next year, I would imagine.
Hmm.
Am I wrong? Or has she once again sent you out to buy, what is it, sesame oil or something?
While we're on the subject, I do wonder why she is so obsessed with using sesame oil in the preparation of mixed vegetable dishes for Lantern Rite. A recommendation from Xiangling, perhaps. What do you think, Xiao?
I've only met Director Hu a few times. I'm hardly the best person to ask.
Ah, and is that not a sign that you should visit Wangsheng Funeral Parlor more often? It wouldn't hurt to grace the parlor with your presence now and again, when you are otherwise unoccupied. This one here is a traditional kite, one without any equipped mechanical device. Director Hu tasked me with studying the differences between the two to determine which one is of greater merit. Many hands make light work. Perhaps you could test out the other kite for me?
All right. I have made my comparisons. If speed is what you're after, the mechanical kite is the better choice.
Wonderful. I shall pass that information along to Director Hu. I'll leave these two kites with you. Perhaps you can find a few friends with which to partake in the activity. You might find it to be an enjoyable use of your time.
Wait. Who enjoys kite flying?
Well, I would imagine someone of your talent and wisdom is more than capable of finding out.
So, you were testing out the kites for Hu Tao and even roped Xiao into doing it for you? Paimon didn't ask earlier because the situation was, awkward.
I would hardly say I roped Xiao into anything. I simply sought the help of a friend. Besides, we did the testing together.
Seems like our pool of competitors is growing. Do you like kite flying, Xiao?
I suppose I neither like nor dislike it. Although, watching a kite gradually ascend into the sky does bring me a certain peace of mind. Perhaps they're a bit like Xiao lanterns in that way.
Kite flying is also a pleasant form of relaxation.
Have you ever thought about making a kite, Xiao? Cloud Retainer taught us how. We can teach you if you want.
There's no need. Minogius was the only Yaksha among us who had an interest in matters of ornamentation and design. When Lantern Rite is over, come find me near Pervasi's temple if you have the time.
It's getting late. I should go inform Director Hu of our findings.
How has she been, by the way? Be sure to say hi to her for us.
The last time I spoke to her, she mentioned that she would be visiting Qiaoying Village in a few days. If you have the time, perhaps you could also make the trip. If you happen to run into her, you can pass along your regards in person.
We'll keep that in mind. Take care, Zhongli. See you later!
See you next time.
Coming.
You can go first.
I don't have anything to say.
Then I'll go. I still don't want to leave Liyue Harbor.
Oh. I can't say I support that decision, but... Hey, let me finish before you get all worked up.
Sit, Shenhe, sit. You must be tired from your journey. Shall I pour you a cup of tea, or would you prefer something else to drink?
No need, I'm not tired. They're gone, Master.
Perfect. The time is nigh for us to make an appearance. Do you remember the plan one recounted to you?
Yes, Master. We aim to give them a demonstration of familial love. So I'll have whatever you are having.
All right.
What are Auntie Xianyun and Shenhe doing here? Just how many people are involved in this scheme? I suppose all I can do is just take a seat and see what happens.
Perfect. I just so happen to have bought some Songlo tea recently. It's quite the delectable variety. Or it would be if one has not been forced to drink it every day in the hopes of whittling down one's considerable stash. One has more than had one's fill already. Oh, forget it. Such thoughts detract from the present need to keep up the conversation. Has work been busy during the holiday season? Do you need my help with anything?
Drunk guests can sometimes cause trouble, but I deal with them as you taught me, by pinning their heads against the table.
Are Auntie Xianyun and Shenhe serious right now?
Oh dear. While one was busy orchestrating this act, one seems to have forgotten about Shenhe's various eccentricities. What I meant to ask was, have you made any new friends? We live so far from each other. It would be a great comfort to me to know you were surrounded by good companions.
You already know of my past circumstances. Recently, I've been conversing with Guoba in the kitchen at night. Guoba can't talk, but his companionship is a comfort.
The poor child. Her one friend can't even talk. I guess maybe Gaming is not doing so bad after all. Perhaps I've been too hard on him.
Let's move on, shall we? Do you have any plans for today, Shenhe? How about we do something fun?
That sounds about right. Take her to do something fun, and perhaps she'll loosen up a bit.
Like we used to do when we would carry stones up and down the mountain from dawn until dusk, picking herbs to eat for dinner along the way? If that is what you ask of me, then that is what I shall do.
Dad, here, have some tea. Or no, wait, let's not have any just yet.
Yeah. Oh, I simply can't listen to that any longer. Coming. I'd like to finish what I was trying to say before. I don't support your decision to stay in Liyue Harbor, because living there is too hard on you. If you come home, there will be people to help you. I'm not saying we have to live under the same roof. I know our personalities are too similar to avoid butting heads, but you'll have your entire family around you. Your aunts, uncles, they'll all do whatever they can to help. You could get a less taxing job, and we could grab dim sum together from time to time.
Huh. I didn't know dim sum was such an important affair, Master.
Shh. Just think about it, okay? You don't have to decide now.
Dad really has changed a lot. He would never have said these things to me before. But I... Thank you, Dad.
It's been long enough, don't you think? hope. I'm on sure hopes they've made up by now. Oh, they're drinking tea in silence. That's not a good sign. Did Xianyun's plan not work after all? Hey, you two! Paimon's sorry we were gone for so long. We got to chatting with some friends and didn't realize how much time had passed.
Perfect timing, actually. We seem to be just about done here.
Yep, let's go. I'll get the vax.
Gaming has grown a lot taller, hasn't he?
Master, did I say something wrong earlier? I tried to go along with your questions, but when I saw how you and that man reacted, I started to wonder.
Not at all. Certain unforeseen variables may have presented themselves along the way, but the outcome proved favorable. The plan was a success.
Then I helped?
Naturally. Your purity of spirit is one of your greatest strengths, Shenhe. You need not change who you are.
You must be Mr. Ip! Thank you for coming all this way. My name is Charlotte, and I'm a reporter from Fontaine. You can find me writing for the Steambird. I invited you here not just to purchase your fine tea, but also with the hope that you might be willing to sit down for a short interview. What do you say?
An interview? To advertise my teas?
I suppose you could think of it that way. We Fontanians are big tea drinkers, too.
The Fontaine Market. Then, I'll need some time to adequately prepare. Perhaps we could sit down and discuss the questions you intend to ask in advance.
Of course, of course! Please follow me!
Is this person also involved in your plan? And here, I thought I had lots of connections. I suppose I've been humbled. You sure know all kinds of cool and important people.
Over here! Yoo-hoo! Over here!
Huh? What? Auntie Shenyun?
She probably wants to talk about the next phase of the plan. Let's go while your dad is still distracted.
I take it that all is going well?
Don't worry, Shenyun. Everything is going according to plan.
I knew it. I knew that was all an act earlier. Auntie Shenyun is really something. She was so determined to help me, she didn't even care about making herself and Shenhe appear foolish in front of my family. She truly knows how to look out for others. I still have a lot to learn.
As for the next step...
Oh no!
What's wrong, Gaming?
Don't tell me you're the ones footing the bill for all that tea. I can't let you do that.
Fret not. Reimbursements will be made.
Exactly! Think of it more as an investment, as Ningguang would say. We pooled together the mora so that Charlotte could place the order. She's gonna bring it back to the Steambird as a gift, as well as a sample of the regional specialty. Fontanians will probably fall in love with your dad's tea as soon as they lay their eyes on Charlotte's article. And once all the money from the new orders begin to roll in, getting our mora back will be a piece of cake!
Oh, okay. Business-related matters always seem to go over my head, but I refuse to let you all lose mora on my behalf. I'll pay you back right now.
We can talk about such matters at a later date. There are more important matters for you to consider at the moment, are there not?
Yes. I've been thinking about it the whole way here. I have an idea, but I'd hate to cause even more trouble for all of you.
That is for us to decide.
Yeah, we're all friends here. Plus, we wouldn't be here if we didn't want to help, right? Just tell us about this idea of yours.
Okay. So, it's like this.
Got it! Just leave it to us! Let's split up and make it happen! We need to do those things we talked about, but we also still have the kite flying competition! Since Xiao already tested out those kites for us, why don't we also go buy one of those mechanical thingamabobs or whatever they're called? We can attach it to our kite!
Welcome back! I see you returned from your trip. I really do have to thank you for all your help from before. Thanks to you, my daughter was able to build a kite with her grandmother that very same day. She even wrote a long letter telling me how much she loved it.
Oh, you should really be thanking Gaming, not us!
I'll be sure to. And are you here to buy a kite? Please, take your pick.
Thingies from Fontaine. Do you sell them separately?
Ah, yes. Here you go. Please, take it, free of charge. The directions are in the box. It's not hard to install at all.
It doesn't feel right for us to just take it.
Well, nor would it feel right for me to take your Mora. Good luck in the kite flying competition. I'll be rooting for you.
All right, then. Thank you. It's done. Let's get down to business. Looks like we finished everything we needed to do. Let's find a good place and put this thing into the sky.
All for my time with the Crocs.
What's going on? Something happened? What should we do? Oh, should we get the mill lift?
Have I taken that many pictures already? I need to load more film.
That's okay?
Thank you, little girl. Do you want us to walk you back?
No need. No need. Master is waiting for me right over there.
Son. I suppose I'll go first this time.
Okay.
Your performance. I've seen many wushou dances in my time, but I've gotta admit, what you pulled off there was breathtaking.
Wow. I never thought I'd live to hear you say that.
You're serious about doing this professionally?
Absolutely. I know it'll be difficult, but...
Then it doesn't matter. What I mean to say is, of course it'll be difficult. But if that's your decision, if that's your dream, then it doesn't matter how difficult it is. As long as you put in the work, then any obstacle can be overcome in time. Really, when I was young, I also... Actually, how about we save that story of my past for another time? All I really want to say is, I've changed my mind. And much like this kite, you also deserve to soar to new heights.
Dad.
Son.
Son? Haven't heard that in a while.
I bet you're wondering what's gotten into me saying all this.
Well, a little bit, yeah.
Anyway, I know I've never found the chance to say this before, but... to me, Gaming, you've always been a great kid. All right, that's everything I've got. Did you have something you wanted to say, or...?
Seeing the two of them talk things through like this really gives Paimon a sense of accomplishment.
Now go. Over there, your friends are still waiting for you.
Huh? But... You came all this way.
I'll be staying in Liyue Harbor for a bit longer. When you have time, we can grab dim sum together. Your treat, right?
Dad, honestly.
Go.
Okay, then I'm off. See you soon.
That's quite the smile you've got there, Gaming.
Really?
It's nothing to be embarrassed about.
I'd like to find and thank Auntie Xianyun, as well as everyone else who's helped me out. If everyone has time, maybe we could all get together and go fly a kite.
Sure, I'll be able to sleep tonight. Oh, that? Yeah, interesting story. It was invented by a guy from Fontaine. His name is Ildison. He's always tinkering away at some mechanism or another. He's even asked the Steambird to write about his inventions on more than one occasion. I believe I have a direct quote from him about this particular one. Yes, here it is. The device is powered entirely by mechanical components without the need for any additional energy source. Basically, it's a manually operated cranking device. How high it can fly entirely depends on how much force you can exert. Combining this invention with a kite. What a great idea, right? Oh, my conversation with Mr. Ip went really well. I've already sent the first draft of my article back to the Steambird. It's a piece that contains all the pertinent information while also telling a story. I'm quite proud of it. Oh, that reminds me. I should thank everyone who made this possible for me. Especially that spirited lady with those peculiar turns of phrase. Miss Xianyun was her name, right? It was all thanks to your connections and creativity. I would have never thought I'd be able to bring such a special gift back to Fontaine with me. This was my first time experiencing a foreign holiday in person. It was so exciting! The festive atmosphere, the contagious holiday spirit, the profound, storied cultural traditions steeped in symbolism. Oh, I almost forgot. Kuching even gave me a kite with a poem on it that she wrote herself. It goes, "Dreams are like paper kites. With them do our hopes take flight. Sailing high above the clouds, they yearn for something more profound. Yet try we may and try we might, a deeper truth waits in plain sight. Though we hang our hopes and skies abound, many joys lie on the ground." I want to include this poem in my special feature on Lantern Rite. I'm sure a lot of people will love it. Yep, and happy Lantern Rite to you.